Grand Erie District School Board recognizes the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe people as the traditional peoples of this territory. We acknowledge and give gratitude to the Indigenous people for sharing these lands in order for us to continue our work here today. In addition to the above Grand Erie District School Board land acknowledgement, we here at Boston Public School strive to deepen our understanding of our local Indigenous communities. We acknowledge the harm and the mistakes of the past, and we endeavor to move forward in a spirit of reconciliation and collaboration. Welcome, graduates, family members, friends, and staff. I'm Mrs. Rodriguez. I'm the principal of Boston Public School. Here we are, virtually celebrating the efforts and achievements of our graduating class of 2021. I'd like to take this chance to thank some of the people who made this event possible. Special thanks to our family and friends who are watching this event and have shown their support to the graduates. Support for elementary school graduates during this time looks very different, but has never been more important for the well-being of our young people. A significant milestone in their lives looks very different than they ever expected it to be. Thank you to the Boston staff that taught this group. Graduates, they wanted me to make sure that you knew how much they wanted to be here to celebrate your graduation with you. Unfortunately, due to the COVID restrictions, they were unable to join us earlier this evening. But you are in their thoughts, and they wish you the very best in your academic journey and next year in grade 9. Thank you to Mrs. Tilson and Mr. Smith for everything they've done for this grade 8 class. They are our homeroom teachers. All year long, they've been empathetic to the needs of their students, and they have been advocating for them behind the scenes, trying to make this year a memorable and special year for them. Thank you as well for all the time and effort that both of you put into planning this event. It's greatly appreciated. But most importantly, I need to thank you, the graduates. I know that this has not been an easy year for you. Grade 8 is a demanding year. Academically, it can be pretty tough, but it should be filled with lots of fun times, many special events, and leadership opportunities because you are the leaders of the school. But sadly, that was not the hand that you were dealt. Your memories are very different. Social distancing, wearing masks, sanitizing your hands, not being able to play with the other grade 8 class, 2 rounds of remote learning, and the list goes on. However, through all of this, you remained strong and respected the situation that we were in. You have shown that you are resilient. You can handle situations and possess the skills to overcome many different barriers and obstacles. I'm so proud of you, Blazers. Each of you have made a contribution to Boston Public School, and it's a better place because each of you. I congratulate you on all your hard work and accomplishments, and I wish you all the best in grade 9. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. What a unique, unprecedented time we find ourselves in. I've been teaching and coaching a very long time, and never have I had 2 grade 8 graduations from the same school fall in the same week, not to mention remote ceremonies. We will definitely remember and learn from this experience. I'd like to start by saying congratulations to all of this year's graduates. I'm happy to see you getting your well-deserved recognition. I've watched you grow into fine young adults throughout your years here at Boston. I'm proud of you and will miss you all. This year I have the honor of presenting the Outstanding Student Award. The recipient of this award should demonstrate high academic performance overall, have a positive attitude, and be an active participating member of the school community. This year's recipient certainly meets all of the criteria. He is a well-rounded, dedicated student who enjoys learning. He consistently completes his work with a high degree of quality. He is respectful to the adults in our school community. Unfortunately, due to the restrictions during this past school year, the extracurricular activities that we usually provide for our students did not occur. In the past, however, this student gave his best and demonstrated good sportsmanship in whatever sport he was participating in. This year, he has showed leadership and commitment by providing our announcements to the student body many mornings and helping ensure the safety of his fellow students by taking bus attendance at the end of each and every day. This student is a team player. He is always volunteering to help out with things around the school. Perhaps most importantly, and what I remember most about him from his primary years, is this young man is a kind and caring individual. Because of this, he is very well liked by his peers and is always there for his friends. He's also acted as a role model to our younger students, treating them with kindness and compassion. He's been an excellent reading buddy over the years. I have enjoyed watching this boy grow and develop into a mature and responsible young person during his time here at Boston. It is my privilege to present the 2021 Outstanding Student Award to Justin Benai. Congratulations, Justin. I wish you all the best next year in high school and in the years to come.
I'm very pleased to be presenting the RTO, Retired Teachers of Ontario, Outstanding Student Award to a Grade 8 graduate of Boston Public School this year. The student receiving this award is very deserving of this award. The student is hardworking and dedicated student, and she's also a good person. The award recipient has a good character, showing respect, kindness, empathy, sincerity, and always treating others with dignity. She is the kind of student that is a good role model for her classmates. The award winner volunteered her time this year as a bus patroller. She was dedicated to taking attendance for many students in the school at the end of the day prior to getting on their buses. This was an immense help to her teacher, Mrs. Tilson. I'm very pleased to present this award to a former student of mine, whom I taught in both grade 4 and in grade 6. The Outstanding Student Award goes to Bella Nydam. Congratulations, Bella.
Hello, Boston families and 2021 Grade 8 grads. Congratulations on surviving this very strange year and achieving your graduation success. I wish you all the best as you move on to high school. At this time, I'm here to present the Math and Science Award. This award is given to a student who demonstrates high academic performance in math and science in combination with a keen interest for the subject areas. Mr. Smith writes about the student receiving this award. This student is 100% in on any math or science lesson. She's the one not only willing to answer questions from the lesson, but answering difficult, abstract, and higher level thinking questions. She loves leading her group in science labs, experiments, and inquiries. This year's Math and Science Award goes to Brooklyn Barnes. Congratulations, Brooklyn. You deserve it. You've earned it. Have a great summer. Take care, everybody. Bye.
I am presenting the Male Athletic Award tonight. Our athletic award goes to a male who regularly involves themselves in school sports by joining multiple teams and performing in track and field events. This student must also demonstrate exceptional sportsmanship skills. Boston's Male Athletic Award goes to Kyle Arthur. Kyle is in many athletics outside of school, most notably hockey, soccer, and baseball. He would have been on every school team if we had them this year. He's an excellent leader in gym and outside when we're playing in teams. He is very complimentary to those without as much talent as him. Congratulations, Kyle.
The honor of presenting the Female Athletic Award to this year's graduating class. This award is given to a student who regularly involves themselves in school sports by joining multiple teams and participating in track and field events. The recipient of this award must also demonstrate exceptional sportsmanship skills. Throughout the junior and intermediate grades, this year's recipient has been an integral part of many school teams, including basketball, soccer, volleyball, and baseball. She always demonstrated excellent sportsmanship, team spirit, determination, and perseverance both on the field or on the court. She had a competitive spirit but always made sure that her and her teammates had fun. At our yearly track and field events, she participated in a wide variety of events, often earning ribbons for her effort and hard work. The recipient of this year's award is also someone who actively participated and enjoyed the many games and activities played during phys ed classes. At nutrition break, she was not someone you would typically see just standing around. She could always be found playing a game of basketball or kicking a soccer ball around with her classmates, and even if it meant just her and the boys. Her love of sports and being physically active continues outside of school as well. She is a competitive dancer, plays volleyball in a recreational league in Brantford, and house league basketball with CYO in Brantford as well. This year's Female Athletic Award goes to Lauren Tyndale. Congratulations, Lauren.
Good evening. The most improved student. A student who has shown exceptional growth both academically and as a member of the school community. I've observed this student over the school year grow more comfortable in his own skin. He figured out a formula that brought him a lot of success in the end. It was, do the work, ask more questions, and hand in assignments. It seems simple, but it works. Congratulations, Dalton Brennan.
Hello, good evening, everyone. Art Award is for a student who demonstrates high academic performance in the arts in combination with a keen interest for the subject areas. When asked to create 1-point and 2-point perspective compositions, this recipient challenged herself and created an amazing streetscape. She puts a lot of time and care into her creations. Her commitment and dedications are shown in her spare time, where she is passionately working on her art piece. It is with a great honor to present this award to Shay Barlow. Congratulations, Shay.
Hello, grade 8 grads. Mrs. Huffman here. I wanted to take this opportunity to wish you all a huge congratulations on this accomplishment. I am excited for all your future adventures and successes. I'm very honored today to present the Language Award to one of my former grade 3 students. This award is presented to the grade 8 graduate who demonstrates high academic performance in language arts in combination with a keen interest for the subject area. This student is an avid reader and continues to flourish in her writing. Even in grade 3, her strong language skills were evident. This year, she has continued to stand out as a meticulous and detailed writer and continues to amaze others with her reading abilities. While on lunch duty this year, I would often see her diligently reading books well beyond her years. She has a true love and strong proficiency of the English language. A huge, heartfelt congratulations to the beautiful Miss Bella Nidham. Congratulations, Bella.
I have the honor of presenting the Ontario Principal Council's Leadership Award. When I spoke to their teacher about this student, I was told that they are an excellent role model, responsible, respectful, and that they show integrity. From all of my interactions with this young man, I had absolutely no reason to question these qualities. I am told that in sports, he always encourages all students in a positive way. I myself saw this many times last year when I would supervise the kids playing basketball at recess. I understand he always completes his work and uses his time in class effectively and appropriately, and that he is looked up to by other students. Also, he's responsible. He completes all of his assignments on time and they are done well. He's respectful. Even occasional or supply teachers compliment him. He has a great sense of humor, but he's really careful never to cross the line into disrespect. He shows integrity. He's honest and upstanding. He's counted on to tell the truth when needed. I understand he's very dedicated to sports and also to his beliefs. He firmly believes that we should have more recess. I hope that he can adjust to high school next year when he doesn't have recess anymore. Kyle Arthur, I only hope you continue to build on these skills and take advantage of leadership opportunities in high school. Congratulations to you on being this year's recipient of the OPC Leadership Award.
Hello, good evening. This recipient comes to class with a positive attitude and works diligently till the job is done. Any obstacles are removed. Any mistakes or faults are corrected. Any unclear directions are clarified immediately so they can get right back to work. This recipient prioritizes their work above all else. No time for chatting with others until their work is completed. This student defines perseverance, someone who has patience, tenacity, endurance, dedication, commitment, and stamina. I'm very pleased and proud to present this Perseverance Award to Janie Dunford. Congratulations, Janie. Good luck and all the best in high school.
I am happy to be presenting the Muslim Association Student Recognition Award. This award is given to a student who has demonstrated an ongoing commitment to valuing diversity and inclusion and demonstrates these beliefs through their daily activities. The student's behavior demonstrates a belief that all are created equal and that we need to treat others as we want to be treated ourselves, with compassion, empathy, and understanding. The student who received this award is an outspoken ally to all races, genders, and sexual orientations. During our novel study on Ghost Boys, a novel about race relations, this student passionately analyzed and discussed the thoughts and feelings of characters and groups from all sides. This student thinks deeply about current events and will always share her opinion. I am proud and honored to present this award to Lexi Ma. To the grade 8 graduating class of 2020-2021, I am honored to have had the privilege of getting to know all of you over this past year, watch you grow in more than just centimeters, and I feel confident you're all ready to take on this next exciting chapter in your lives. Right from the start of this unusual year, I knew this was a special class. We have had our fair share of antics in the classroom, from cries of more recess to cries of cardboard falling. And yet you all remained respectful and mostly completed your schoolwork. You survived both a year of school and two sessions of remote learning. You have lived and learned through a period of time that will be written in the history books one day. You rose up to this challenge, and I can sincerely say that you all weathered it wonderfully. You're an amazing group of students, and I can't wait to see where you go from here.
Greetings. Thank you for welcoming me into your school this year. We had a great year together with lots of laughs, navigating public health expectations, and some memorable moments like trying to make a Christmas video of Feliz Navidad and pranking the other class on April Fool's. I wish I could convince all of you this is an exciting time, but you're just gonna have to find out for yourself. I'm excited for the experiences you'll have in high school. The added freedom coupled with added responsibility. You're ready for new friendship possibilities. You're ready to start making choices about what to study. You're ready to find your people. You're ready for it. Know that you're welcome always back at Boston to drop by and say hello. Thank you, parents, for the support you've given these grads over the years, and especially this year. Thank you, grads, for supporting each other. Thank you, staff, for helping to put this all together. I'd now like to announce our valedictorians for the 2021 year. Bella Nidham and Lauren Tindall.
Dear Grade 8 graduates, families and friends, administrative and teaching staff, my name is Bella Nidham and I am honored to be the valedictorian of the Boston Public Schools graduating Grade 8 Ms. Tilson's class. Steve Jobs said, "Here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs in the square holes, the ones who see things differently. They're not fond of the rules. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify them, or vilify them. But the one thing you can't do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward, and while some may see them as crazy ones, we see genius. Each one of us in this graduating class is unique in our own ways, normal in our own ways, crazy in our own ways. Genius! We all came together in the last 10 years to help shape whom each other will become. We bonded to each other in JK and SK through playing together, learning, and attending each other's birthday parties. We created friendships that may last a lifetime. In grade 1 through 8, we learned about many subjects, but we also learned how to get along, be a good friend, keep your friends' confidences, and how to support each other, except for when certain people, and you know who you are, would steal my books, which is not supporting me, it's just plain cruel. Or when several of you would push each other off the large rocks and almost give me a heart attack. By the way, I still carry band-aids with me wherever I go. Speaking of supportive, our graduating class has many people to thank, so here it goes. First, thank you to Mrs. Rodriguez for attempting to keep us all in line. Your efforts did not go unnoticed. Second, thank you to Mrs. Tilson for endlessly putting up with our shenanigans. Our class would like to give you the Patience Award from unnamed individuals hiding a smart board remote, being muted on Teams meetings. You remained patient with us and never lost your sense of humor. I know I speak for the whole class when I say that you made our last year memorable and we truly appreciate you. To Mrs. Ryersey, thank you for being so supportive and for allowing us to discuss personal issues during health class. Madame Nassar, thank you for broadening our horizons with the French language. And to the Boston Public School support staff, thank you for keeping the wheels of education rolling, even during a pandemic. We are the graduating class of 2021, and I can confidently say that this grade 8 class is special. We have had to overcome circumstances that no one has had to before. Not our parents, not even our grandparents. We are the class of COVID-19. Even with the challenges of online learning and feeling like we have had our year cut short, we are all still here and we are still smiling. There has never been a year more fitting for the saying, "It doesn't matter how many times you fall, as long as you keep getting back up." We have been made stronger by our ingenuity, empathy, and perseverance. We have been relentless in our pursuit to excel in our circumstances, and we have supported each other to victory. So, fellow graduates, let's take some time to pat ourselves on the back for having the guts and strength of character to make it to this point in our lives against all odds. We have reached the end of a chapter, but we still have so many more chapters to write. Book reference. elementary school experience have given us the skill we need to create a masterpiece. The same guts and strength of character, along with support from our family and friends that got us to this point, in spite of a pandemic, will also carry us successfully through our futures. To the graduating class of 2021, I say well done, my friends, well done. Oh yeah, and one more thing. Go Blazers! We got pom-poms.
Hello, class of 2021, teachers, parents, and friends. Due to the graduating class being so involved in social media, I feel that references to it will be needed for this speech. Hashtag thank you for understanding. Enjoy this TikTok made for you.
Tell me you're graduating during COVID without telling me you're graduating during COVID.
I'm so nervous.
Oh, don't be nervous. It's only 5 minutes. Here's your mask.
Oh, look. There's your teacher.
It all started for me at Boston when I walked into Miss Ryerson's kindergarten class in October going every other day. Everyone was sitting on the OG rainbow carpet. My first day was great. I got to play with a cool caveman Lego set. The next day I knew I was accepted into the Blazer family because I had to fight for a turn to play with the Lego set and building blocks. Just like everyone else. Hashtag the Backyardigans.
Into the thick of it! Into the thick of it! Into the thick of it!
It is hard to sum up our last 10 years at Boston in 3 minutes, but I'll try my best. I think we should be proud of the friendships we have built and the hard times we endured. Such as being in the middle of a pandemic right now, losing out on our class trips, sports teams, heck, even lockers, hashtag struggle is real. I know we are grateful to have the pre-COVID memories to carry us through, such as all our trips to Bacchus, like playing the survival game, or hearing the strict lady talk about school in the old days. Swimming at the Safari Splash Pad, coming back from our grade 4 trip with Miss Bowers, and pretending Andy's coming with our swords. Going to cage with our soccer team, surprise attack on a parent volunteer in the ball pit at the museum, stopping for ice cream after volleyball, school fun fairs, hashtag pie in the face. All these memories prove how much we need each other to succeed and to smile. And remember, every step of the way, we have always been proud to represent the Blazers, hashtag small school.
When the moment comes, you'll say, I did it all.
The class of 2021 would like to thank the internet, Google, Wikipedia, TikTok, and Snapchat for being there for us. Just kidding. We would like to give a shout out to Boston teachers who have taught us along the way to accept each other's differences, turn our weaknesses into strength, and maybe even extending a few project deadlines. Thank you to our parents for listening when we need to talk, talking when we need to listen, and upgrading our Wi-Fi to meet the online school demands. Mr. Smith was shocked to learn about country internet, hashtag country life. And to not disappoint, my friends, I would like to leave you with a meaningful quote from Millie Bobby Brown. You have to make some noise if you want to change the world. This is something we all can do. Look at Waterford High School. Here comes Boston 2021. Hashtag stay strong and good luck, everyone.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you.
And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes warm. All the ones who love you in the place you left, I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes
on top of